Hey guys, welcome back. We will discuss another example of the conditional formatting in the pivot table by making use of a formula. Let's see an example of the conditional formatting in a pivot table using the formula. For this, we will first generate some data with the list of students along with their subject, the subject marks, and the project points. First, let's prepare the data. Okay, now the requirement is to summarize the data in a pivot table. Then we need to highlight the students' names in the respective pivot tables. Whoever meets the criteria. So to meet the criteria, to create the criteria, we will use a formula. Okay. Then the conditional formula using a formula, conditional formatting using a formula in the required cell range can fetch the required output effectively.
আমি বলছি আমার ওনাকে বলতেছি আমি এর উপর পড়ে তেলি কাপড় ধরে এর তেলি মার কোদরে ছা মারতিরি নি বন্দি গা
আমি যাই দেখো আমি
Now the data is ready. First, we will choose the data set and we will insert a pivot table and we will drag the columns appropriately to create a pivot table. Let's do that first. Okay, so as you can see, we have included the pivot table. Now, what we can do, we will, if we select this option that we want to use a formula to determine which cells to format, so we can add a formula there. We can add any simple formula, okay? We can also add OR condition, AND condition, okay? Now we will add a condition for two adjacent cells, in this case B36 and C36. So the B36 cell has the sum of project points and the C36 has sum of subject marks. Now we can add a AND condition. The AND condition will return true if and only if all the expressions are true. Okay. So we have to be careful here. Now, if I want this row 36 to be highlighted using the AND condition, then I should give the expressions that will return true. For example, if this particular student has scored less than 50 in the project points and less than 300 in the subject marks, then we can expect a true value. Then this particular student will be highlighted. If any one condition fails, then the output will not be true. The student will not be highlighted. So I'm not showing you any exact criteria here. It's up to you to apply a criteria so that you can successfully use the AND condition. And you can see the syntax of the AND condition. You have to specify the cell number of B, you have to specify the cell number of C, and the two criteria. And you can apply a AND condition there. So try it out and see if you get it correct. Okay. So here B36 is less than 20. So 38 is not less than 20. So this will fail here. And C36 is less than 50. So here it is 261, which is less than 50. It's not true. So both the expressions will be false. So you will not get the AND condition successful here. Like this, you can apply this particular condition where this B36 is less than 50 and C36 is less than 300 and try if it works. And you can give a format, appropriate formatting. You can apply a color coding there and see if it works for you. For me, it didn't work because both the expressions are false. So we will see a few more examples, few more such examples later in our upcoming sessions.